In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon and welcome. I invite you all to take a seat. I welcome all of you who join us here in St. Patrick's Church, and indeed I welcome to those of you who join us from your homes today, as we come to say a final farewell to Peadar O'Dowd. I always begin a funeral mass by saying that we come together from different angles of a person's life. And when you think of it, we all know people in different ways. We have different kinds of relationships with those around us. And today, as we gather here to say goodbye, we bring all of those relationships together. And we bring many, many different sets of memories. Today we say farewell to a husband, a brother, a neighbour, a former colleague, a friend, a true Galwegian. We all come with different sets of memories. And these memories, of course, are very special now, because Peadar has left us. So just for a few moments, as we gather here now to begin our funeral mass, I'd like you to recall the last time you met him. Where was it? What was your conversation about? I'd like you to recall too the great times that you spent together with him. And again, we all have those different sets of memories going through our minds now. For you, Mary, and the immediate family here in the front seats, you have one set of memories. For you who met Peadar every day, close friends of Peadar, people like Father Declan DC here behind me, a close friend of Mary and Peadar. So you, the close friends, have your own set of precious memories today. Maybe some of you here this afternoon remember Peadar from your school days. Perhaps you shared a classroom with him in the old St. Brendan's Primary School in Woodquay, or back in St. Mary's College in the 1950s. Or maybe you were part of the graduation BCom class of 1962 from the college. These are precious memories of yours today. Perhaps you have fond memories of Peadar from the badminton court, from lovely summer evenings out in Black Rock, or from great days you spent up the Corrib, when you talked a lot about the ones you caught and the ones that got away. Precious memories now. You may remember Peadar, of course, as a staff member, a colleague, or maybe as your lecturer in the early years of the RTC, later to become the GMIT. where Peadar spent 33 very happy and fruitful years. Perhaps you were in his lectures in the early years in the Office Information Systems course. Later on, of course, in the Heritage Studies courses. Peadar was so much part of that college until his retirement in 2006. Your memories may go back to the RTC, the GMIT, which is now ATU. You may have memories of the great nights you spent with Peadar researching some story, preparing one of his publications, preparing one of those 20 plus books that he published over his lifetime. Today I welcome Father Martin Whelan here, who worked with Peadar on various projects and publications for the diocese, not only for the city, but for the diocese as a whole. Again, many of you will have fond memories of your research with him in preparing, in discussing, in planning. Some of you here today will have memories of the various organizations that you were part of, along with Peadar. And again, we know he had leading roles in so many Galway organizations, like the Galway Archaeological and Historical Society, the Old Galway Society, the Galway Civic Trust, to mention but a few. I'm sure you have many fond memories of meetings and discussions and projects that you were part of with him. Maybe you have come here today never knowing Peadar personally, but you knew him through his writings. He gave you a sense of belonging to the place we call Galway. And that's why you were here today. So I welcome you all then as you bring all of these thoughts and memories together. I welcome too among us today Commandant Brian Walsh, representing Uachtaráin Éireann, Mr. Michael D. Higgins, who was unable to be with us today. Thank you, Commandant Walsh, for your presence among us. I welcome the mayor of our city, Councillor Eddie Hoare, representing the City Hall and representing the city as a whole. Thank you, Councillor Eddie, for your presence with us too. We prepare ourselves to pray and to remember and to honor. As we remain seated now, let's just pause for a moment, recollecting our little sins and our failings and asking for forgiveness as we prepare to pray this Mass as worthily as we can.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my thought, through my thought, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Hear na Jane Throkera. Creast Jane Throkera. Hear na Jane Throkera. Guimish. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Peadar, for whom today we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, he may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
He is full of energy and his arms show his strength. He reaches out his hands to help the needy. He is strong and dignified and looks with confidence to the future. He speaks wisely and his words are kind. He keeps an eye on the conduct of his household and his words are never idle. His family is blessed by his presence. May he enjoy the fruits of his labor. Amen. This is the word of the God. Amen.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Near restful waters he leads me, to revive my drooping spirit. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, with these you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Second reading, a reading from the book of Timothy. As for me, the hour has come for me to depart. The time has come for me to leave this life. I have done my best in the race. I have run the full distance and I've kept the faith. Now there is waiting for me the prize, which the Lord will give me on that day. And not only me, but to all those who wait with love for his coming. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. You have the message of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, I tell you most solemnly, whoever listens to my words and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. Without being brought to judgment, he has passed from death to life. I tell you most solemnly, the hour will come, in fact it is here already, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and all who hear it will live. For the Father, who is the source of life, has made the Son the source of life. And because he is the Son of Man, has appointed him supreme judge. The Gospel of the Lord. Did you ever pause and think of how important words are? The words we speak and the words we use every day. Words are very powerful. Words can do great good and can do great harm, as we all know. When somebody uses the phrase and the words, I love you, or I forgive you, these words build us up and do great good. Words can be damaging and bring us down too. Somebody might even use the phrase, I hate you, I don't like you. These words can be so damaging. Words can bring about transformation. Every time you come to Mass, you hear words spoken like, this is my body, this is my blood. Words are powerful. They bring about change. Words can inspire. A child can be told, you can win, you can win. Words are inspiring. Words can instill fear. When the weather forecaster says, there's a red warning issued, words bring fear. Words cement relationships. Two people deeply in love face each other and they say, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer. Words cement relationships. Words are powerful. Today we are saying farewell to somebody who used words a lot. And we have great and fond memories as we come here today saying goodbye to somebody who loved the written word and the spoken word. Somebody who used words as a hobby, but in using his words as a hobby, made all of us Galwegians so aware of our heritage and so aware of where we have come from. Back in 1985, Peadar O'Dowd published a book entitled Old and New Galway. I was reading the introduction to that book last night. The introduction was written by Dr. William J. Hogan. And the last few lines of the introduction goes as follows, and I quote, he said, let Peadar O'Dowd act as your eyes. Explore the city with him. And when you arrive back where you started, you will truly know Galway for the first time. Powerful words too. It goes without saying, of course, that we live in a city now that's rapidly changing. Changing in size, in society, in culture, in colour, in language. But I've no doubt that Peadar's huge and unique contribution to local heritage will only grow and become more important as the years go on. The other day, in fact, the other morning, very early, I dropped a friend of mine down here to the coach station across the road. It was 4 o'clock in the morning. And as I was looking around me, standing in the middle of this big hall, with all the activity going on around me, I couldn't help but thinking, you know, who's going to tell the bus driver from Bratislava or the cappuccino maker from Croatia that the ground that they are standing on is the fair ground, the fair green, where our ancestors, only a few decades ago, bought and sold calves and other animals. We live in a city of great change. And therefore, I feel that Peadar's 20 plus publications and his thousands of newspaper and magazine contributions will only open more windows from the past for future generations of Galwegians in the years to come. His contribution will surely grow. For all these new people who are coming to live among us, become part of our Galway. But today, as we come to say goodbye, we're inspired by other words too. Today we listen to the Word of God. Again, powerful words that we have heard in today's readings. Words that always have a message for us too. The first reading we heard there today from the book of Proverbs, one line struck me. The one line that stood out for me from that first reading was, "He speaks wisely, and his words are kind." Today we thank God for a man who was full of wisdom and kind words. The second reading we heard there is very familiar to many of us. It talked about fighting the good fight, finishing the course, keeping the faith. Well, Peadar did all of those things. And today we come to hand over his spirit and his soul to the merciful love of God. Today, of course, we come face to face with some very big questions. The end of life always brings big questions. Death brings big questions. We might very well ask ourselves, where is Peadar now? Has he met those who have gone before him? Will we see him again? And of course, we have no clear answers to any of those kind of questions, because death is a great mystery. But again, the words of the gospel come into play. We hear in the words of the gospel today words that give us hope and give us a promise that death is not the end. And in the gospel there today, we heard, "I tell you most solemnly, whoever listens to my words and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life." What words could be more clear or more direct? Whoever listens to my words and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. Nevertheless, of course, today is a day of loneliness and loss. And I always feel it's my duty to offer our sympathy, in particular to the people here in the front seats before all of us. Today, on behalf of all of us, I give you our sympathy, Mary. And I give you too our sympathy, Willie and Martin, Peadar's brothers. To the in-laws, nephews and nieces here with us, grandnephews and grandnieces. To the neighbours, again the former colleagues from the RTC GMIT. And as I give you our sympathy, I'd like to mention one very close and lifelong friend, Bernie O'Hara. We give all of you our sympathy today. On days like this too, I like to remember those who have gone before us and gone before Peadar. And today You'll have memories of people like his father John and his mother Bridget, his aunt Julia, his sister Nono Hession. We remember Thomas and Mamie Langan. And again, so many friends from so many different angles of Peadar's life who have gone before him, one by one down the years. Former colleagues too, from the staff of RTC of old. In particular, people like Eddie Fox, who established the Heritage Studies course with Peadar. On days like this, I often say, as we say farewell, many are saying welcome. And finally, Peadar, as we turn to your remains once more here today, we know that in so many ways your spirit will live on in your words on our bookshelves. But we know too that your spirit will live on in a different realm, a different kind of existence, in the presence of God. And as you go from us now into that presence of the living God, may you rest in peace. That was not for me, it was for him. We stand. We're going to pray our prayer of the faithful. And as we turn to the Lord in faith and in prayer now today, we put words once more on some of our thoughts and memories as we gather here remembering and praying today.
In baptism, Peadar was given the pledge of eternal life. May he now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Peadar and all the deceased members of his family. With our trust in God, we hope that Peadar is united now with all his loved ones, his parents, Bridget and John, Sister Nono, and his Aunt Julia. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Peadar, who we love and will miss dearly. We will remember and cherish the good times we all shared together. May he rest in peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Peadar and the doctors and nurses and other staff that cared for Peadar during his stay in hospital. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Shinni Arguiho, Thri Kriest Orgirna. Amen. We sit now once again today. We bring our gifts of bread and wine to the altar.
Thank you.
God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And so we stand now and pray together once more, and pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant, Father, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And so we kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop, and all who serve God's people.
Remember your servant, Peadar, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Once again now, we stand here in the presence of Almighty God, and as we are together in prayer, both here and as we join from home, Guimish Kunarnahar Fimaravunar Sloni Hurdu in Ayenav. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And as a sign of peace here today, we offer to each other some kind of friendly gesture.
this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who gave eternal life to us who receive it.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. If you have a celiac condition, there will be celiac hosts available here on the table right beside Pather's remains. We'll now have a word of thanks from Pather's nephew, Daniel.
Good afternoon, everyone. Mr. President, Mayor of Galway. Firstly, it's a great pleasure to be standing up here, speaking on behalf of Mary and the O'Dowd family and the Langan family. Auntie Mary has asked me to thank a few people who have assisted her in the week gone by. We would like to thank Irwin's funeral home for organising Pather's funeral and removal last night. We would like to thank Father Abbott, Father DC, and Father Martin and Pat Whelan for the beautiful ceremony last night and today, and St. Patrick's Church, where Pather spent so much time down the years. We would like to thank Tommy and Anne for their music and singing today. We would like to thank the doctors, nurses, and staff of University Hospital Galway, who made Pather feel comfortable and gave him amazing care. We would like to thank the family, friends, and neighbours of Pather, who've been so supportive over the past week. I personally want to thank Auntie Mary, who has been always at Pather's side and was his rock since. Pather was so inspirational for his family, his nieces and his nephews. We all idolised him. He was the ultimate role model for us all. Pather set the tone for the O'Dowd family. He set the tone as a husband, a brother to William, Nono, who sadly passed away a few years ago, and Martin. And he set the tone as an amazing uncle to all his nieces and nephews. We all know Pather loved swimming in Black Rock. I actually thought he was mad, but he was a trendsetter. He also taught our family how to swim, my brother and sister, a life skill we will be forever grateful for. He introduced me to the River Corrib at a very early age by bringing me on boat trips. As an oarsman, the River Corrib played a huge role in my life. And in later years, Pather and I used to have the odd clash on the river when Pather would wash me down and nearly sink me. Pather inspired the city of Galway through his words and writing. He wrote numerous books about Galway and about various institutes in the city. He wrote in the City Tribune and Sentinel for over 30 years. He was one of the founders of the St. Patrick's Church magazine. He carried out city tours for all the tourists visiting Galway. He was a lecturer in the GMIT for many years, teaching many, many students and spreading the history of Galway City. He was a true Galwegian. We as a family loved attending Pather's book launches, as it filled us with great pride and it inspired us so much down the years. Pather gave so much to the city of Galway. He represented the Galway people through his words and writing. He wrote a book called The Spirits of Galway. Well, for us, he is the spirit of Galway, and his spirit and legacy will live on forever in this great city. Uncle Pather, thank you for inspiring Galway City through your amazing words. Rest in peace, Uncle Pather, and we'll never forget you. Thank you.
I invite you now to stand with me for the final prayer today. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Pather, who today has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. We'll now come to pray our final prayers of farewell. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
The response is, receive his soul, present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. The angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Peadar in the sure and certain hope that, together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
May the angels lead you into paradise, may the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem, and may you have eternal rest. I now call upon Father Declan here to lead us with the final prayer, which is a family prayer that Mary and Peadar always said in their home.
As Father just said, and Anne told me, this is an old family prayer. May the Lord support us all the day long, till the shadow has lengthened and evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then in his mercy, may he give us safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last.
We might just take a seat for a moment. I think there are still some people who wish to offer sympathy here. And if you do wish to offer sympathy to Mary and the family, please come up the center aisle now and go to your left.
Thank you.
So I invite you now once again to stand with me for the final hymn of our Mass today.